Today we're going to be talking about one of the most important parts of your audio system, the DAC. Why is it so important? Well, we'll get to that. But of all the questions that we get here at Moon Audio, most of them are about DACs. So we scoured the web for some of the top questions that people ask about digital to analog converters. And we're here to answer those questions to give you everything you need to know about DACs. This first video will just cover some of the basic questions on DACs, what they are, how they work, how to choose the right one for your system and needs. In later videos, we'll get to specific connections, how to set them up, and of course, some of our favorite DACs out there. So let's just get to it. Ross, feed me some questions.
Question number one, Ricky, the big one, what is a DAC?
So DAC, D-A-C, stands for Digital to Analog Converter. It's a component like in your phone, in your tablet, in your computer, audio device, whatever, that processes the digital data of your music and converts it to an analog signal. Once it has been converted to an analog waveform, you can send that to your amplifier and play the music on a speaker or headphones. Think of it as a translator. It's just taking that data and translating it to an analog signal that you can hear.
All right, question number two, Ricky. How does a DAC work?
So a DAC is essentially the Google Translate of your audio system. Apart from the physical analog media like vinyl and tape, most music today is digital, just ones and zeros. And since our ears can't hear digital data, we need a method of converting these ones and zeros to an analog format so that it can produce sound waves and thus we are able to hear it. The digital to analog converter does just that. It converts the digital data to an analog signal. It takes those ones and zeros and it tracks them to a waveform pattern. To do this, it converts the bits of data from the stored files onto an analog electrical signal at thousands of set times per second called samples. The DAC outputs these samples into a waveform that intersects at all the sample points. However, problems can arise in the conversion process, which we'll get to in a little bit, that can set some DACs apart from each other. It's an integral part of your system that you can't do without, especially if you have a digital music library.
All right, Ricky, the next question, number three. Why do we convert digital to analog?
So the basic fact is that our ears are not designed to hear data. It's impossible. We can only hear analog signals like sound waves and vibrations coming from an amplified source through the air. Therefore, we need a device that converts this data to an analog signal. The other factor has to do with the fact that most music today is recorded digitally. This means that the analog signals coming from the instruments and the voices being recorded are stored digitally onto computers, mixed, mastered, and then optimized for digital mediums such as compact discs or online streaming and downloading. Analog media like vinyl and tape is making a comeback, but still the majority of music and access to that music out there is digital. And ultimately you need something to convert that data before you can hear it.
Question number four, Ricky. What makes a good DAC?
So I would say that the quality of the converter chip itself doesn't necessarily play the biggest role in determining how good a DAC is. In fact, the overall audio signal path needs to be considered if we are specifically talking about like the sound quality of a DAC. That being said, off-the-shelf factory DAC chips like in your phone are not very efficient or accurate at converting the data. So the result is a fair presentation of the music, but it really leaves much to be desired. A good DAC chip converts the data efficiently and accurately so that all the information in the data is transmitted to the analog signal. More data points results in a smoother waveform, thus resulting in like a more natural audio quality. Having multiple DAC chips can also make a difference in the effectiveness of the data conversion that is outputted. Higher-end DAC chipsets are usually like Cirrus Logic, ESS, AKM, or Burr Brown, and of course there are others, but these are just some of the most popular on the audiophile market. Some DACs themselves, if we're talking like just the device itself, might not even use proper off-the-shelf chipsets. Cord DACs use FPGA and their own proprietary algorithms, and they sound phenomenal. This is just another reason why you can't simply just look at the chipset or lack thereof to determine if a DAC is good or not. You have to look at the complete picture, or in this case, the whole audio circuit or architecture from start to finish.
Question 5. What kind of DACs are there, and what do I need for my system?
So here at Moon Audio, we like to divide DAC types by ergonomic scenario. So do you like to listen to your music while on the go? Do you travel frequently? Then perhaps a portable DAC like the Cord Mojo or Claris Coda would be appropriate for your personal use. USB DACs are a perfect portable option. They're small, just throw them in the bag, you're good to go. Do you like to listen to music in the comfort of your home, or perhaps have a designated space for your sound system? Then a desktop or tabletop DAC would be a great fit. The Hugo TT2 is a great option, and the Cord Hugo 2 is a powerful portable DAC that can also serve as a dual purpose DAC in your home system as well. There are many kinds of DACs for varying usage scenarios, and sometimes audiophiles use multiple types, so they always have good audio quality wherever they are, whether on the road or listening at home. Now, we could get into differences of like AKM, ESS, R2R, Burr Brown, Cirrus Logic, and more, but that just gets a bit technical and nuanced, so we'll probably save that discussion for another day. Now, DACs also come in variations and configurations like standalone, or combined with streamers, or headphone amplifiers, or servers, and more. So you have like your Cutis DAC, which is just a standalone unit, just the DAC, and actually one of our most popular DACs that we sell here at Moon Audio. Next is something like the Bricasti M3, which is a DAC combined with a headphone amplifier. Then you have devices like the Name Unity Atom HE, which combines the DAC, a headphone amplifier, and a streamer. And then there's things like the Arnder A20, which is everything. It's a DAC, it's a headphone amp, streamer, and server, complete with internal storage for your personal music library.
Question number 6, Ricky. Does an external DAC make a difference?
Absolutely.
Maybe a little more information?
Okay. So without a DAC, your digital data can't be converted to an analog signal, and thus you won't be able to hear it. Every device you have, or rather every device that has a speaker, has a built-in DAC. Your phone has a DAC, your AirPods have DACs, your tablet and laptop have DACs in them, your portable speaker that you take to the beach has a DAC in it. The more important issue here is that not all DACs are created equal. So we mentioned again that the DAC is like the Google Translate of your audio system, right? It translates the digital data to an analog signal. Are all language translators the same? No, they vary by skill. And the same applies to internal factory DACs and external ones. An external DAC is built to do one thing and to do that one thing very well. That is why external DACs that are built for the sole purpose of converting this data are completely better than factory off-the-shelf converters.
All right, Ricky, next question. What devices do not need DACs?
So since the DAC's job is to convert digital data, analog sources don't require a converter, right? So devices like tape decks, turntables are great examples of gear that read directly from the analog medium, that is like tape and vinyl respectively. The device basically reads the analog signal in real time, and then through the help of an amplifier, it transmits that signal to like some headphones or speakers, whatever you have set up in your system. It's an easier and more direct process than that of, you know, doing digital. And that's how things were done for the longest time before digital came onto the market.
Question number 8. Do I need a DAC for my DAP?
Sorry, can you say that again?
DAC for my DAP.
DAC for your DAP?
Yep.
Okay. So most digital audio players come equipped with a high-end digital to analog converter, right? Which attributes to the premium cost of the device. However, upgrading from a stereo receiver to a separate preamp, an amplifier, can elevate the sound performance of the system. So two, can using a DAP as a digital source and adding a higher performance DAC on top of that can do the same thing. For example, if you own, say, the brand newest Allen Kern SR35, you can use it as the digital source with the Cord Hugo 2. And thus, the Cord Hugo 2, since it provides a superior sound over just the SR35 by itself, pairing the two together would result in awesome, awesome sound. But it's not necessary, since the DAP itself, the SR35, already has a high-end DAC chip in the audio circuit. So, no, you don't need a DAC for your DAP. Yeah.
Question number 9. Do I need a DAC or an amplifier?
Well, it depends, Ross.
Oh, tell me more.
Do you have a DAC or do you have an amplifier? Because you need both, okay? So it depends on your system, right? So a DAC cannot substitute for an amplifier, and an amplifier can't substitute for a DAC. If your system doesn't have something to convert the digital data to an analog signal, then you're gonna need a DAC. If your system doesn't have anything to power your speakers or your headphones so that it can amplify the signal, then you need an amplifier. So sometimes there are devices that have both, right? They have a DAC and an amp, like the Matrix Audio Element X2. So there are many devices, both portable and desktop, that have both a DAC and an amp. We call those essentially DAC amps. But if you are without one or the other, then you're not gonna hear anything. You're not gonna get any sound, so you need both. If you aren't sure about what you have or what you need, feel free to contact us and we'll be more than happy to help you out.
Last but certainly not least, what is the best DAC, Ricky?
Huh, that's a tough question, Ross.
Can you answer it?
It's a tough answer, okay? So perhaps the better question to ask though is, what is the best DAC for you, okay? So there's a lot to consider in each case. Each person will likely have a different answer because at the end of the day, we all hear differently. And we all have different setups, we all have different budgets and on, we'll get into proper portable and desktop DAC recommendations in a later video, but keep a few things in mind here when considering what might be the best DAC for you. Number one, budget. How much do you want to spend? Two, ergonomics. Where are you going to listen to your music? Three, what is your current audio system? So DACs have various IO, input and output options. So picking one that is compatible with your system is key. And number four, what type of sound or sound signature do you prefer? So it all depends, right? And these factors help determine what is the best DAC for you. It's how we approach our customer service here at Moon Audio, making sure that we help you figure out what works best for your specific system, your music, and ultimately your ears. I think that should be enough for now. We'll go over some more questions, connections, setup options in our next videos. DACs are an integral part of your sound system. So I feel like there's never too much we can go over. And of course, there's certainly not a shortage of questions to be asked about DACs. So if you have any questions, please leave a comment below and we'll include it in our next video. We'll also include a link to our What is a DAC guide in the description below. So be sure to check that out for more information. If you like this video, be sure to give a thumbs up and remember to subscribe so you don't miss our latest reviews and videos here at Moon Audio. And as always, thanks for watching. Of all the things we get questions here about, we get more questions here like about DACs than any other device. Of all the questions we get the most, we get the mostest questions. Of all the questions at Moon Audio, the most that we get of those questions are about DACs.
Most of them.
Most of them. Most of the questions. Yeah, not all the questions, but most of them. Okay, yeah, we got that. Bye-bye!